Good afternoon. My name is Maryann, and I'm here to give you some tips on sewing and using a sewing machine, especially if you're a new sewer or quilter. Most of your sewing machines now are electronic, unless you have an older model. Mine is a little Janome electronic, and I'm going to show you how to thread it. I always wind my thread coming out from the top, and usually this one has it. It has numbers on how to sew it. So you put it through the top one, which is number one. You bring it down, all the way down. That's number two. You bring it back up, and you're going to catch it over here. And then you bring it back down, and you'll put it through this little thing here, and then you put it through the needle. And some of the bigger sewing machines have a needle threader. I'm going to have to just thread mine myself. I can see. It helps actually, if you can't see the hole in the needle, to put a piece of white paper or cardboard, something behind it. Since I have some white fabric here, I'm going to try that, and it makes it a little bit easier to see the hole to thread it. There, that worked. Okay, so my top thread is already threaded now. The next thing you want to do is thread your bobbin. And one of the things I learned when I first started to sew was, because I could never remember whether you put the bobbin in with the thread coming to the left or the right, they always told us the perfect P. So it's coming on the left-hand side. You're making a P with your bobbin and the thread that's coming out of it. You insert it in the bobbin case. You put it through the little hooks and things, and when you make your first stitch on the sewing machine, it'll pull the bobbin thread up. Okay. And sewing machines usually come with several different feet, but you can buy other ones to go with it depending on what your needs are. This foot here is called a quarter inch foot, and it's got a little ledge on the side, as you can see. And when you put it in your machine, you just put it underneath the thing and pull it down, it hooks right in. When you're using this, you can make perfect quarter inch seams, which are really wonderful from when you're quilting. When you're doing regular sewing, usually you're doing a half inch seam, so you wouldn't want to use this foot. This machine also has, and a lot of the machines now do, it has a little storage case, and it has different feet that you can use. It has the clear feet, has different ones there. This one is wide enough, as you can see, that you could actually use it for a zigzag stitch. Here's another foot. And another foot. A lot of people like to use the clear foot because they can kind of see where the fabric is and what they're doing. This is an extra thread holder. You can have your thread coming off the top this way, or you can have it where I have mine there. When you have this part off your machine, you have a nice free arm here. If you were doing something with like a shirt cuff or something where you want to slide it on, or some type of tube type sewing, you could use this to slide it on, and you can, you know, sew without this extra part on it. The foot that I like to use because I'm a quilter is this quarter inch foot. And you can't really use it for anything unless you're making a quarter inch seam. It has a ledge here. I don't know if you can see that. When you have it on your machine, if you run your fabric right along that ledge, you'll end up with a perfect quarter inch seam. So you would take your fabric and you would just put it right there by that quarter inch foot and go ahead and sew, and it would give you the quarter inch seam. Now, if you're doing other sewing other than quilting, normally you would use a half inch seam. Quilting is one of those areas where you use the quarter inch seam. It's very important, particularly with quilting, that your seams are accurate. You need to make sure your fabric is cut accurate, and then you need to make sure that your seam is accurate. And that's why I like this quarter inch foot. With regular sewing, you can do the half inch seam, and there are markings on your plate on your sewing machine which show you how many inches or half inches or quarter inches your way. But you can also put a piece of masking tape on your sewing machine for the half inch seam or whatever you're sewing. Or if you don't have the quarter inch foot, you could make a seam using one of your regular feet. And when you get it to where the you want it for the quarter inch, put a piece of tape there. A lot of the newer machines have a needle that will move either to the left or the right to adjust the width of the seam. And those would usually be buttons on the front of your machine that do that. This is what the front of my sewing machine looks like. And as you can see, you can do a zigzag stitch or a straight stitch. This is how you would regulate if you want it closer together or less wide, I should say. And this is wider. This is if you want the stitches to be longer or shorter. If you're using a zigzag stitch, you have to make sure that you have a foot that will allow the needle to go back and forth, or you're going to have a broken needle. This here refers to the chart down here. And if I want the stitch to be right in the middle of my machine, I'm going to use the one. If I want it to be a locking stitch first, I would use two and so forth. So this first button here will go up to 14 stitches. And then it goes back to the one. 15 stitches, I'm sorry. And then it goes back to the one. Then this next one is really for buttonholes. And it starts with the 16 and it goes up to 30. Then the next one starts with 31 and it goes up to 46. And then the last one starts at 46 and will go all the way up to 60. This machine has 60 different stitches that you can do. Some of them are just zigzags and straight stitches. Some of them are buttonholes. A lot of them are decorative stitches. Very nice machine, especially if you're going to take it to different classes or you want to start a machine to see if this is something that you really do want to do in the future. Some things that you'll need besides a sewing machine and thread, and you need to get a thread that's suitable for machine sewing. I like cotton or polyester and cotton. If you're using scissors, that's fine. If you're doing quilting, there's some extra things you're going to need besides a quarter inch foot in the sewing machine hole. These little clips come out really handy if you're clipping things together before you make the seam. Instead of using pins, you can use these clips and then you take them off as you go along. Another thing you want is a rotary cutter. This is a 45 millimeter. It also comes as a smaller one or a larger one, a 60 millimeter. If you're cutting through heavy fabrics, you might want to use a 60 millimeter. If you're doing some mini quilts, you might want to use the smaller one. This will also, with the cutters, I like this one a lot. Some of them have a little button where you push the blade in or out. And you should always leave it with the blade covered when you're laying it down so you don't accidentally pick it up and cut yourself. The blades are really, really sharp. This one I like because when you cut, the minute you put it down on your mat, the blade comes out. And the minute you pick it up, the blade's covered again. You can see it has this coverage on it. So nobody's going to get cut with it. There's all different kinds of blades. If you're doing a lot of quilting, they tend to wear out quickly. You're supposed to use a new one every time you do a quilt. I like these titanium blades. They're very, very sharp, and they last longer than your regular blades. They're also a little bit more expensive, but I think they're really worth the difference. Scissors. And you should never use your sewing scissors on paper. That really wrecks the blades. So you should have separate scissors if you're working with paper, if you're cutting out a pattern or something, and use your sewing scissors just for fabric. This is a kind of ruler that you use for quilting because you take your rotary cutter and you line it up with the edge and it just cuts right along there. This one has markings in black and also in the bright kind of yellowish green color. And it goes as small as an eighth of an inch if you need to measure a piece of fabric that's 2 1/8 or whatever. So this is a real nice ruler to use. This is another cutting mat that I like. I have a couple different cutting mats. If you're making something with large, long strips, you want to use a larger cutting mat. This one, though, is perfect for a lot of the cutting that you would do. And it's a rotating mat. So if I'm cutting here and then I need to cut on the other side, I can just rotate the mat without maneuvering my whole body with it. When you're cutting with a mat, you're supposed to use your ruler for the measurements rather than the mat measurements. The ruler is supposed to be more accurate. So you'd put your ruler wherever you want to go, but use the markings on the ruler instead of the mat for your things. Even though this does have 1/8 inch markings on it too. Nice mat. So those are the things you need extra if you're going quilting as opposed to just sewing. You need good sharp scissors for sewing, but you need the rotary blade for quilting. Straight pins are great, but if you're quilting, these clips come in really, really handy. If you're doing a binding on a quilt, and you turn it over like this, and you're turning it over the main piece of the quilt, you just take these clips and hold them right in place. You don't have to pin. That's one of the things I really like. All the machines are a little bit different, so it makes sense for you to read the manual with it first and then just follow that. But I would experiment with all the different designs that are available to you. I know sometimes people have made a piece of fabric and have gone through each of the designs and the different widths so that they can refer to it, and then they mark it on the fabric so they can say, oh, I like that stitch and that's the one I want to use. So that's another technique to kind of let you see the stitch, what it's really going to look like on the fabric as opposed to just looking at it on the chart. I think that's about it for first-time sewers with threading your sewing machine and using it. Thank you for your attention.